They were all living the castaway life until help arrived. These are some of our best stories about being stranded and saved. In 2018, warmth was on the way for some American scientists who got stranded on an island off the coast of Antarctica. The group was conducting research at Joinville Island, where a U.S. icebreaker was unable to reach them. They requested help from Argentina, which sent its own icebreaker and a helicopter. The team was airlifted to the icebreaker and brought back to South America, where they were able to set foot on firm land instead of walking on ice. In 2016, this puppy was presumed dead, so her owners were very happy to learn she was found alive 5 weeks after being lost at sea.
This is not a day that we thought would ever happen.
Luna was on a fishing trip with her owners off the California coast. 1 minute she was on the boat, but the next she wasn't, and she was nowhere to be found. The Navy was called in, and they conducted a search but had no luck locating her. Weeks later, Luna was spotted walking down a road on a nearby island, and her owners were notified that she had been found.
When I became the CEO, I never thought that this would happen, but this was definitely a good story.
Officials say Luna had to swim 2 miles from where the boat had been to reach the island. In 2018, 7 puppies cried out for help from the shore of an uninhabited island in Canada. The 7 castaways caused rescuers to dub their mission Operation Gilligan's Island.
Here on Gilligan's Island.
A reference to the popular 60s sitcom about 7 people stranded on a desert island in the Pacific Ocean. The puppies were all named after characters from the show, from Gilligan to Marianne. But these puppies weren't faring as well as those humans did. They were found underweight and starving. Rescuers say they didn't know how the dogs got onto the island. They were spotted by boaters who alerted the rescue organization that they might need some help. Once the puppies were taken off the island, they were given the care they needed to get them ready to be adopted by loving homes. In February of 2021, 3 castaways were lucky to be spotted by the Coast Guard on a desert island in the Bahamas. A surveillance plane spotted a flag with unusual colors on the island and decided to get a closer look. That's when they noticed people signaling for help. 2 men and a woman were on Anguilla Cay Island for a month before they were found. The Coast Guard says they are Cuban nationals who survived by eating conch and rats. They were also able to set up a makeshift tent for shelter. In August of 2020, 3 sailors used the universal sign of distress to signal their need for help when they got stranded on a remote Pacific island. They spelled out SOS on the sands of Piccolo Island, which is part of the federal states of Micronesia, hundreds of miles from Guam. The island is often visited by wildlife explorers, but no one actually lives there. The Micronesian sailors were there for 3 days when their plea for help was seen by a search team on an Australian and U.S. aircraft. The sailors were all found in good health. In 2015, Inside Edition's Stephen Fabian attempted to make contact with a woman stranded on an island while doing research. Dr. Diane Cowan is an expert on Maine lobsters. She became isolated on Friendship Long Island when the surrounding waters froze, preventing boats from getting to her.
Dr. Cowan's about a mile this way. The only way to reach her is by boat. And to do that, we gotta break through the ice.
Stephen soon learned his mission would not be easy.
So you can see the thick ice here that's surrounding her house.
But as he inched closer, Dr. Cowan waved from the dock on her island. Stephen wasn't going to give up now. Eventually, he gets close enough to tie up his boat and make contact with her.
Oh, a human face!
I know, it's been so long. How long were you by yourself here?
35 days.
But their time together was cut short when Dr. Cowan noticed conditions were changing.
What was that?
A big ice chunk just moved.
Guys have to leave.
Is that it?
Yep, the tide's turned.
She politely kicked Stephen off the island, but left the door open for future visits.
It's been a pleasure. You're welcome here anytime.
All right, we're coming back.
Thank you.
If he can get there, that is. For Inside Edition Digital, I'm Mara Montalbano.